Around the end of our Kentucky season, David DeHart and David Hale are doing what they enjoy, hunting high-pressured longbeards. Understanding that calling tactics must change during this time of the season, basic clucks are all this hard-hunted bird will hear. Knight and Hale's push-pull box is the call of choice for these hunters. It's simple and very realistic sounding. Plus, these guys have used their wood skills to sneak inside 100 yards before they made the first call. The gobbler is within easy Mossberg range. He is hoping to draw the hen out to his strutting. This is when a hunter can learn about a turkey's nature, if you can stand to watch him instead of immediately taking the shot. Now, here's another spring turkey hunting tip.
Folks, I know you're wondering whether I'm going to eat these mushrooms or not. I don't know whether they're poisonous. I don't know whether they're edible. But you can bet on one thing. I'm not going to find out. But you know, one of the greatest things about nature, where are you going to go to find beauty other than in the outdoors? And every place you go has got its own set of beauty. And speaking of that, being outdoors, one of the things that's asked me about as much as anything is, what all do you carry in your vest? What's necessary when you're out there filming versus when you're just hunting? Really, there's not a whole lot of difference, but one of the things we want to do here is just go through real quick what we carry in our vest that is very, very practical. And believe me, when you carry as much weight as we do, we don't take anything extra. First of all, here's a little item right here that's beneficial to every turkey hunter. It's called a ratchet cutter. How many times have you had a limb that was in your way? You just reach over and clip it out of the way, and you're ready to go when you hadn't got to be up twisting, turning, carrying on. Next thing I've got in my vest is a pair of binoculars. I try to carry a little set. Now this right here is a 10 by power. It's called the UFC mini series from Pentax. I like these little 10 by 21s because it's in numerous times I've had to look out in a field or somewhere and try to identify whether it was a jake, a long beard, whether I wanted to fool with it, whether it was a hen. They're very, very handy. I've always got them with me. Of course, everybody carries calls. There's no need of me going into, most everybody's got 15 different calls in their pack. You're not going to find me without a pair of little strikers or some kind. These are called fighting purrs or push-pull. You know, Harold and Chuck don't let me call much. But when they do, you know what they always ask me to do? It's as a last resort. When they can't make him come in, they'll say, David, pull out your fighting purrs and see if you can get the job done. It doesn't always work, but boy, I sure do feel good when it does. And it serves as a second little purpose. That sounds great when you're out chunning. Simple little bitty calling, and lots of times we get too fancy. And you're going to find me doing very little, but what I got to say so quietly with those little boxes usually means something. Next thing you're going to find in my little pack is always some kind of candy. Now, this is not very important, but it's in mine. There's a little sucker, a little piece of bit of honey, and I'm not promoting those products, but boy, do I ever like them. They're in my pocket. Always got a face mask or two, because every time I take one off, I lose it. That's the reason I wear a half mask. I can pull down around my neck. Always got an extra pair of gloves because I set them down and being camouflaged. And I think that's the reason they camouflage gloves, is so you can lose them and have to buy them again. And boy, they have ever gotten me. Okay, of course, we can't eliminate the fact that I've got to carry plenty of shells. Even though it doesn't take but one to kill a turkey, I'm not going to tell you how many times we've missed turkeys, and I'm certainly not going to show it to you. But I can tell you one thing, when I carry a turkey load to the woods, it's going to be Winchester Super X, Double X, and I'm going to carry the copper-plated fours. I think that's the load for me that really does the job. And it certainly patterns best in my old reliable Mossberg gun. You're not going to find me anywhere without that because I can use a 3.5-inch shell all the way down to whatever I want to use in it that's legal. Another thing that we need to be concerned about, and you're going to always find in my little ditty bag here, and it certainly better be in yours, and that's just Duranone tick repellent, because ticks are out in the springtime. They're tough on you. A lot of times you got a bad case of them, don't even know what you got. It'll take care of chiggers and ticks. That is a great product. Spray it on your clothes. It's not foolproof 100%, but it's a close you wouldn't know the difference. And of course, then they let me occasionally, the guys do, blow an owl call. I don't know whether they think I'm better than they are or whether they think that's the only thing I can blow, but I usually get the owl call in the morning. And right at the break of day, I like to give that old and listen. Get everybody away from me so you can hear the answer. And if you don't hear it, so I guess if I was in an owl calling contest, they might enter me, but then again, they might hurt my feelings and said that's the only thing they'd let me blow. But I have got that in my pocket. And then I look back here in the back of my vest. I'm going to have me an old decoy back here. And if I'm going to carry a decoy, I'm going to carry me one's got motion to it some kind of way. I can sit back here with a string and pull him and give him a little of that. That's called a Higdon motion decoy. Always got one of those with me. Because in filming, you got to get the turkey's mind off of something besides your calling when he comes in. And then when you have a year like we had this year, boy, did I ever have to tote rain gear. Always got me a rain vest in here. It covers up the camera if I need to. Certainly covers up me if I get caught too far away from a truck. That's 10X. It is a super garment. And then, of course, another thing is, this year was most valuable. I've always got an umbrella. Buckwing puts out a little umbrella here that's so small and so portable, and you're not a sissy if you pack one. I used to think I'd never pack one, but boy, when I got to fooling with equipment, cost a lot of money, you don't want to get wet. And this little umbrella can tie around a tree and you can sit under it. I remember one hunt this year when old Harold was looked back there at me and I was under a raincoat, under an umbrella, and he didn't have nothing. And I didn't offer him any of mine. These are just some little things that I carry in my backpack every day, not counting all the stuff that you carry. And of course, I do carry the toilet paper. Chuck uses it to white balance his camera. But Harold's got other uses for it. I don't think I have to go in detail, but this is just some of the little things that we carry every day in our backpack.
I'm gonna tell you what, I'm just about sick of these walking gobblers. They ain't 2-year-old turkeys, Dave, them old turkeys.
Well, this is about the third or fourth pasture field he's been through, and you know what he's doing.
Oh, yeah.
This is about 10 o'clock in the morning. He's going from field to field, and he ain't got hens with him.
That's right, he's looking for
it. And he'll answer your call, or he'll gobble at a crow call. How many times have we been on those kind of gobblers?
Well, I tell you what, we're going to kill that turkey.
Well, no more than I've heard since I've been up here in Illinois.
Yeah.
Of course, it's been raining, it's been windy. We're going to stay with this turkey. And I swore I'd get off of a walking turkey, but here we are.
I've got plenty of clothes on, I know that.
Well, let's go see if we can get on it.
It's just over the top of it. I've got to get a few so far. You can answer to
he'll answer that, I bet you. See? Told you.
Very well.
All right, now look. We can't go that way. It's too much pasture for you.
Let's go right here. Go around.
This ridge, let's follow it all the way down to the end. He's done made a big loop. We're on his circle.
Let's try to get ahead of it.
Let's get ahead of it.
Then we'll set up.
No more of these turkeys have been gobbling and answering calls. We better put that decoy out.
All right, he's right over that hill,
right in that depression down there. Let's get in this brush pile right here and we'll stick the decoy out and see what happens.
Mm-hmm. You gonna put it there?
Yeah. What about it, Bubba? What's that thing up? Suggy fried chicken. I knew what was next for you.
Well, it's off to the check station for Knight and Hale with their big gobbler, a 22-pounder with 1.5-inch spurs. Definitely a trophy. Yes, this really is New York. Not the big city we all think of. It's the country where real maple syrup is made and trout-filled streams flow through rich mountain valleys. This is dairy farm country, and this habitat is perfect for the eastern wild turkey.
Guys, y'all see that big gobbler up yonder?
Do we?
He's by himself the way I see it.
I like that being by himself.
Do you think we can call him from here? We need to get a little closer, Harold.
Ooh, we need to get a lot closer. If we're smart, we'll get a lot.
David and Jack Baltz from High Tech Boots send Harold back 50 yards to do the calling. Getting set up quickly is sometimes important. These ratchet cutters are essential for trimming unnecessary limbs. Our hunters have gotten close to this gobbler, and it's late morning when the hens usually try to slip away from the toms.
Well, Harold, one of the things that I've really noticed up here about these New York turkeys, they've got a lot of color in their tail feathers.
Yeah, they have.
And one of the things that probably that most people would be interested in is, I know you got the talent for calling, and you get a two-year-old bird that cooperates like this, what kind of call was you using?
David, I was using a four-reed call. It's going to be a new call we're coming out with next year. We haven't even named it yet. But I gave Jack one, and everywhere I go, I give somebody one of them. It's a real easy call to cut and to call real raspy with.
Well, boys, what do you say we put these high-tech boots to the test again and stomp out some more of these strings?
I think that's a good idea.
Here's the scenario for this hunt. Walter Parrott is in southern New York. It's state forest ground, 45 minutes after daylight, and Walter has two gobblers within calling range. These birds didn't gobble until they hit the ground, probably because they've been hunted every day for 2.5 weeks. Just enough calling to get a longbeard interested is all you need when there's been this much hunting pressure. Walter's Hunter V3 mouth call has definitely got the old bird in a courting mood. It might just be a different sound from what he's heard all spring. Notice the characteristics of this old turkey. A quick strut, and his head is up looking for any movement. He has made his commitment. Now it's the time to let him look for you. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Ain't this pretty up here on this mountain?
Jack, it was too much. A turkey or two this way and a turkey back this way.
There's two that we heard dialing down there and one coming over here. We've been up here now about a half hour. If we probably get set up, we ought to be able to get a shot at one of these birds.
Why don't you see if you can even start it, Dirk, just to...
I'm going to tell you what, this dog is unreal. About 9:30, it's time for him to be away from him here.
That's right.
How far was it?
He about 150 yards.
Yeah. David and I can get up on this hill, on this knob right here, and you back off behind us in case you need to go off.
Jack,
I'm going to hit him a little bit with glass.
The Knight and Hale boys are in New York, atop a high ridge in the Catskills, with their hunting companion, Jack Baltz. With David Hale on camera, he and Chuck move out ahead of Harold and Jack's calling position. Chuck's ultimate glass and Harold's shock and cutter diaphragm and new Silver Queen aluminum friction call are firing up these mid-morning gobblers. Thanks to Real Tree Camouflage, this gobbler has no idea the crosshairs of a Pentax turkey scope are trained on him.
Well, guys, we had a great spring. Is the fall going to be as good to us?
Well, I hope it's drier.
It was a wet one, wasn't it?
I'll tell you what, Dave, we went from the south to the north from 90 degree weather to snow in one day. And, you know, it's hard to adjust to that turkey hunting. You know, it's pretty weather. You feel more like turkey hunting than you do when it's snowing.
Well, you know what, Chuck? That's kind of like elk hunting. Up on the mountain, it's 25 degrees. Down in the valley where you come back down to, it's 60. You got to wear clothes for both occasions. You got to pack everything out there for every circumstances. this filming is not what all it's made out to be.
No, it isn't. My best day last spring was when we were in New York, and you woke up and we'd been driving. Harold looked up there and he said, "That's snow coming off that mountain." And David said, "Oh, that's buds blowing down out of there." And Harold said, "How come they melting on the windshield?"
I was badly fooled. I couldn't believe it was May. We done come from some hot weather in the south all the way to snow in the north. But you know what? We had a great spring. I'm glad we got to go north this year. Those turkeys up there, I'll have to admit, some of those northern boys told us, says, "You ought to come up here and hunt some of these turkeys. You find out how tough it is." It was tough.
Yep.
You know, a turkey, adult turkey is adult turkey from the south to the north. You know, he knows how to survive most of the time, doesn't he?
That's exactly right. He's a survivor. Well, guys, you know what? We've got two new videos right now in the making as we're sitting here. One of them is our third edition of the Ultimate Whitetail season. And you know what? We just finished up our Ultimate Elk video.
Boy, was it good.
I tell you what, any elk hunter or any turkey hunter that wants to look at something that's really exciting, he needs to look at that new elk video because it'll turn you on.
What have we got, 9 or 10 good hunts right
now? We got
now?
9 or 10 good hunts. Boys, we got, you heard this said many a time, a turkey hunter will make a good elk hunter.
Right.
Because it's an active sport. A turkey's gobbling, an elk's bugling. And son, we got some footage of elk bugling at 8 yards right in our face just before the arrow was let loose. And you talking about nervous as a cat on a hot tin roof? I was.
He's bragging again.
Oh, yeah, arrow. But I tell you what, I noticed one thing he didn't do, Chuck. He didn't pick that big 800 or 900 pound elk up and throw it over his back.
No, he didn't. He didn't head off that mountain with him, did he?
Well, folks, let me tell you, we've completed our third edition of the Ultimate Spring. And I know it was exciting to you. It certainly was exciting to us. But we're going to give you a little teaser of some up-and-coming video footage, especially on the elk. And if you're interested in any of Knight Hale products or any of the videos, and you want to get on our mailing list, we'll put the slate up at the end of the video. All you have to do is call us at our 800 number or write us, and we'll be glad to send you some information to get you on the mailing list. In the meantime, guys, our work's cut out for us for the third edition of this whitetail video. Now, Chuck, you've already spilt the beans a little bit. We've got
We're one up.
We ain't saying which one shot a deer, but hopeful all three of us gonna get one before the year's over.
Can I say who shot him?
No. He is lucky. I'll give that away.
He's lucky in a corn crib rat.
Well, I'm gonna tell you what, y'all want me back on that camera bad. Y'all fixed it up where I could get on there quick. Okay, guys, we'll see you next time on a brand new edition of one of these Ultimate Spring videos.
Let's look at a few scenes from the best upcoming elk video available, The Ultimate in Elk Hunting.